Good morning, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. A Lineboro teenager has several broken bones and other internal injuries after falling 100 feet into a quarry. Police say the 17-year-old and several friends were trespassing at Pike Quarry when the boy fell. Rescuers had a hard time reaching the teen because of the terrain in that quarry. It's not known what his condition is this morning. Concord police call it a disappointing crime. On Saturday night, surveillance cameras recorded a man stealing a donation jar from the counter of the Irving Circle K on Loudon Road when the clerk's back was turned. The collection was for the Concord Regional Food Program. In its 39th year of distributing holiday food boxes to thousands in need in Concord and 17 surrounding communities, they say the few dollars stolen is always important when donations are needed, but it's not a setback.
It's unfortunate, but you can understand it too. You wish it wouldn't happen, and maybe the person really needed it. But we hope that, as always, Concord will rally like it has.
Concord police say the thief got into a silver or gray van with plastic covering a broken window. If you have any information, you're asked to call the Concord Regional Crime Line. Senator Warren Rudman has died at the age of 82 after a long fight with lymphoma. Rudman served as New Hampshire senator for two terms in the 1980s.
Because it's their personal judgment as to whether you will rise or fall.
The senator was known for his direct style and willingness to go to battle for what he believed in. A longtime friend, our own Fred Coker, would go on to join Rudman for 12 years in Washington, working with him on perhaps his signature piece of legislation.
Graham Rudman Hollings' deficit reduction law in the 1980s, if that had been left on the books by Congress, we wouldn't have the fiscal cliff right now.
Even after leaving the Senate in 1993, the Republicans' ability to reach across the aisle was exemplified with an offer from then-President Clinton to be his Treasury Secretary. You can find out much more on Rudman's career and how he's being remembered by other leaders here on our website. The Portsmouth Police Department is hosting a special football game tonight, all to benefit victims of Hurricane Sandy. A total of 8 teams made up of local police and fire departments and members of the military will participate in the Portsmouth Police Turkey Bowl 2012. The game gets underway at 5:30 p.m. tonight under the lights at Portsmouth High School's Dobney football field. The goal of the game is to raise money and donations for victims of Hurricane Sandy in New York and New Jersey. That's it for this webcast. We'll have another update around 1 this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.